So I finally got my 27-gallon cube by Marineland from PetSmart. It was a gift from my beautiful wife. And I've been kind of itching for one of these for quite a while. But anyway, I just finished painting the back, somewhat of an electric midnight blue. Krylon Fusion. Take some time, some patience, but I didn't get. Actually, I did this in my apartment. Don't ever do it in a closed space. Reason for me doing that was because my complex, pretty much, they get on you about anything and everything. But it dries in 15 minutes. There's a beautiful gloss to it, somewhat like it was done by a machine in a factory. I'm pretty excited with it. You're gonna get to see me peel it off and see what was the outcome. If I did any mistakes. I'm also gonna try keep putting videos. Doesn't matter because it's on the black. But I'm gonna keep trying to give updates on this tank and how it's coming along as time goes on. So that everyone could see. It's gonna be salt water. I was complaining that this tape was really cheap. Actually, it just needed some time to. Painter's tape. It's a nice tank, it's roomy. Haven't had one in a while. I have a little 10 gallon that I've been trying to just play with to keep measuring my measurements and my salinity and pH. All that other good stuff. Not be so rusty as when I finally get into another tank as I just did right now. As you can see, my wife got me construction paper for my kids. Came in handy. Not just for school. And this tank is normally $289 at PetSmart. They have a sale right now where it's $199. The cabinet had a scratch. It was minor. I got a 10% discount on top of that. After the 10% scratch, it didn't bother me as much. Take your time when you're doing this so that you don't have no blue paint or whatever color you choose. I like this blue better than that aquamarine blue. Bunch of dead rock sitting in the storage room. I have to clean that. Select some nice parts, pieces that I like, and fit in here. Put the rest back. I used to have 125 gallon aquarium. Are blue, and that's why you shouldn't do this inside your house because of the mist. Thank God I didn't damage anything. I don't think. Anybody who's interested in this tank, I've seen a 30-gallon version of it. Just taller. I like this one because I can reach into it, move things around, and I live in an apartment, so. If I ever have to collapse this tank, it won't be as heartbreaking. Put everything in 5 gallon buckets. Get it to where it needs to go. I'd like to give a shout out to New York Stilo. Give me advice on a protein skimmer. Thanks to him, I'm on a manhunt for the Aqua Remora C. Hang on back. Skimmer. Haven't found it yet. I'm gonna keep it simple, no sumps. I don't want the over flooding. I'm not home if there's a power outage. Finally got somebody to help me with the camera. My wife. I normally have to do videos on my own. And this is not like an unboxing where you juggle it with one hand and put it on a tripod in front of you. Almost done. Pretty sure the tape is off. Pretty excited with that finish. Maybe get a good shot of that. It's extremely glossy. Excuse the quality of the video, as it's not 1080p. I'll connect the light for you guys, so you can actually see in the back. The nice thing about this aquarium comes with a double bright LED. Oh,
probably do some softies until you get a better lighting. It's your moonlight. It's your bright light. The daylight. And I'm happy with that blue. That looks like a deep blue. Now you can't see the wires. Neat job. I'm happy. Well, guys, I'll keep you posted. And thank you, honey. I'll keep you posted. That's my little 10-gallon, which is going to be drowned into this for beneficial bacteria, along with a bunch. So it's going to be like 50% water change, or 60, which is just fine. Some live sand, rocks, weight, acclimate some cleaner pack. Got my little pub table there. And this little aquarium. It's in a conversation piece right here. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you have any questions, comment, feel free.